Hi everyone, and a very warm welcome to all of you. My name is Madhulika Rachahan, mother, author, green energy enthusiast, and a certified Lean Six Sigma Black Belt expert. Through these videos, I would like to take you all to a journey of understanding the concept of Lean, famously known as Toyota Production System, fathered by Taiichi Ono, a man who dedicated his life to the concept. Today's video is a continuation of the series we started in the last episode of ESG and how Lean methodology should and can be used to drive ESG results. Efforts to integrate environmental considerations into Lean and Six Sigma have sometimes been labeled as Lean and Clean, Lean and Green, Lean and Sustainability, Lean Ecology, or Lean Six Sigma. These terms can be useful in drawing attention to efforts to integrate the parallel universes of Lean and environment. At the same time, these terms can imply that environmental considerations are an add-on, something distinct and separate from Lean and Six Sigma, deterioration from full integration. Even though there has been much progress, however, there are still remains a lot of scope for more opportunities in the areas. Dramatic progress has been made during the past 20 years in commercial and industrial sector environmental management. Focus on end of pipe cleanup and regulatory compliance has expanded to prevention pollution at its source and considering broader environmental sustainability objectives in organizational decisions. Environmental professionals have enabled this transition. The results attributed to environmental management, pollution prevention and environmental sustainability initiatives are impressive. Advances in four key areas are helping organizations across diverse sectors realizing compelling environmental and economic results. First being, environmental tools and expertise help businesses and other organizations minimize waste, prevent pollution, and move towards more environmentally sustainable processes and products. Environmental Management System, or EMS, institutionalize environmental management activities and foster continual improvement. The business case for environmental activities influences an increasing number of business decisions as case studies and analysis demonstrate the benefits proactive environmental management can have on bottom line performances. And fourthly, businesses are increasingly experimenting with paths to sustainability, incorporating corporate social responsibility and triple bottom line thinking into the core fabric of business strategy and operations. Despite this progress, there is a still significant opportunity to improve environmental performance, further reducing the environmental footprint of production processes, products and services. Given the numerous environmental and economic benefits of environmental initiatives such as EMS, pollution prevention, design for environment, and other environmental and sustainable initiatives, one might expect that it would be easy to get companies to implement more environmental efforts. Typically, however, these initiatives have a difficult time competing in the corporate culture. One misconception that environmental professionals sometimes have is that if more people knew about the benefits of environmental opportunities, organizations would do more. An obvious implication of this argument is to invest in more information diffusion and technical assistance. If you could only get the wealth of environmental management tools that exist into the right hands, more would be done. While this thinking is clearly important, there is a reason to suspect there is more to the story. A well-known and documented study of pollution prevention activities at Dow's Midland, Michigan chemical manufacturing plant found that the more common barrier in environmental and P2 project implementation is the internal competition for capital and management time and attention. As it turns out, a positive return on investment is not always sufficient. Capital projects must clear internal hurdles that weigh the value of each alternative while using limited capital. Even small projects that require limited or no capital investment must compete for limited organizational time and attention. As a result, more and many promising ideas, environmental and others, end up cutting floor room because they are not viewed as central to business success. This challenge has spurred many environmental professionals to seek creative ways to attract attention and organizational investment for environmental improvement opportunities. It is in this context that Lean Manufacturing and Six Sigma have emerged as powerful vehicles for delivering the same. So if an environmental initiative pay, why don't they compete as well as we could expect? Lack of awareness of environmental opportunities and tools tell only a part of the story. Internal competition of capital management attention may be a more powerful barrier. While it is not necessarily easy, initial results from leveraging Lean and Six Sigma businesses improvement methods to advance environmental goals are definitely promising. Lean and Six Sigma have legs. Businesses, organizations, and government agencies are aggressively expanding the use of Lean and Six Sigma as core strategies for addressing competitive market pressures affecting cost, quality, and customer demand. Lean is driving change in numerous commercial and industrial sectors, ranging from automotive, aerospace, and metal finishing to healthcare, construction, and even wood products. Lean's bias towards action and rapid improvement creates staying power, which helps Lean avoid a repetition as a favor of the month. Even while commitment to Lean and Six Sigma varies significantly across organizations, many view implementation as a long-term journey that will require sustained leadership and organizational commitment. Lean and Six Sigma can effectively complement environmental initiatives thus. Environmental professionals have long contended that to make sustained environmental improvement that moves beyond what you call as the low-hanging fruit, an organization must create a continual improvement-focused waste elimination culture. Lean and Six Sigma seek to create a very similar and highly complementary organizational culture focused on continual improvement. In doing so, they use tools that are similar to many being used by environmental professionals, such as visual mapping of the processes and root cause analysis. By connecting environmental initiatives with Lean Six Sigma deployment efforts, environmental professionals can help environmental implementation ideas compete more effectively and embed them in culture-changing processes, improvement practices. When the plant floor is being reconfigured and operations are being changed through Lean Six Sigma, the marginal cost of incorporating environmental improvement ideas is definitely low. So I leave you with a few examples. Baxter Healthcare. A Baxter Healthcare facility in US Southeast conducted 3 days value stream mapping events focused on water use and develop an action plan to save 170,000 gallons of water per day. That was amounting to $17,000 within 3 months with less or little as no capital investment. With this project, the facility no longer needed to expand its water waste treatment plant. Second, Cannon Creek Cabinet Company. Through a combination of value stream mapping and week-long Kaizen events, Cannon Creek saved almost 1.2 million per year, and that I'm talking about in dollars, $1.2 million per year, and reduced volatile organic compound, also known as VOCs, emission by 55,000 pounds per year, and decreased hazardous waste by 84,400 pounds per year. General Electric. General Electric conducted over 200 energy treasure hunts, a lean strategy for identifying waste at facilities worldwide from 2005 to 7. This effort cut their greenhouse gas emission by 250,000 metric ton and saved close to $70 million in energy cost. So with this, I come to an end of this edition. I leave you with a thought as to what lean and environmental efforts combined can accomplish. Don't forget to like and subscribe and comment in the comment section on what you'd like to hear more. Until next time, this is your host, Madhulika Rajahan, signing off. Have a wonderful day ahead.